At the time, there was a lot of people making music that sounded like shit in the club. When my record came on, I wanted the record before that to sound low, because my shit was mixed so good, and the 808 was so big, and the production just sounded crazy. All of my records, I would push them to the limit, push them to the edge. I would mix them so they just sounded ginormous in the club. I started to get better with my production. Whenever I would make an album, I'd just go to the store and buy some new gear. I hadn't really heard anybody use, like, basically a techno kind of synth on a hardcore rap song. That synth and the 808 matched so well together, and that definitely became my signature sound.
Low, that was the personification of what crunk became. When you saw them crazy motherfuckers in them videos, you saw what crunk was. It's almost like if somebody could take the term lit and make a whole life out of it. That's what Jon did. He took it and made a genre of music out of it and took it to the world.
And we were watching MTV, and we sitting at home. It came across the bottom. Lil Jon, the Eastside Boy, Get Low, number one song in the country. Pick that phone up. Hey, man, why we sitting at home? We got number one song in the country. Then I knew we really made it when we did a show, and the white women started popping up, showing the titties. Remember that?
Yeah.
White women started popping, showing the titties. I said, hey, we made it.
We there.
Nigga, we made it.
When you do crunk songs, you have crunk ad-libs to hype up the crunk vocals. Yeah, what? Because when you turn up, you go, what? 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 Okay. Dave Chappelle thought it was funny that I do these ad-libs on all these songs and ran with it in the skit, and that pushed it over the top. He made it where people are going to be screaming at me till I die. Shit.
Lil Jon and the Eastside Boys.
Because that was such a big crossover record. Uh-huh. You had the Yin Yang Twins, had all the white people saying, skeet, 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 not knowing what it meant. Everybody, skeet, 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 skeet. You hear it on the radio. It's like, they're talking about ejaculating on people's faces. And they're playing that without bleeping it. You know what I'm saying? That's when you're like sitting back and you're laughing to yourself going, okay, there it is. You know what I'm saying? We really changed the game here.